Hello, I'm Tal, the developer of Animation Layers addon for Blender, and I want to go through some of the new features in the addon. I will first add a basic layer for the head looking around. I will use the reset key to reset the head values in the layer. This operator has been there for a while, and I recommend using it instead of the influence when it's possible, since it basically lets you reset the influence per bone. I've added a new Inbetweener property, which blends between the keyframes per layer. When entering values over or below the 0 and 1 limits, then it will push the pose. The last thing that I've added to the layer tools is Multikey. Multikey is a tool for editing multiply keyframes and is also available as a free standalone add-on. It's a tool that I wrote and used before writing animation layers, and I've decided to give it an update and also add it to the animation layers add-on. First, I need to turn off the auto key. I select the keyframes I want to change, in this case I'm just selecting all the keyframes. I change the pose of the character and hit edit selected keyframes. The new values are added to all the selected keyframes. You can see this also in the graph editor, how all the values are being added. This is similar to the propagate tool in Blender, but it's easier to use and also works with NLA animations. It is also similar to Animbot's global offset, however it's not working when auto key is turned on. The scale property is scaling all the selected values. Instead of scaling curves in the graph editor, you can quickly scale the values in the viewport using multiply factor value. Randomness will add a random value. A filter was added to filter specific properties. The location, rotation, and scale can be excluded when using all the layer tools. Now let's add another layer with another action. We select the action from the layer settings. We change its blend type to replace. You can see that the layer is renamed automatically. That's because the sync layer action names is turned on. Now it is possible to use custom frame range per layer. And going into custom frame range, there are new options available and the add-on goes into some kind of NLA mode. There are now more options from the NLA available. However, those settings are more simplified. Instead of using action frame range properties, I've added only offset and scale properties. I changed the extrapolation of the second layer to nothing to be able to view the bottom layer animation. The extrapolation of the first layer I changed to hold, since the second layer doesn't have any keyframes on the face controls, it will use the keyframes from the bottom layer because of the hold extrapolation. I will also add some keyframes to the influence to blend between the two actions. I can use offset to try to find a good point where the two actions blend with each other. I smart bake everything into a new layer. And now I can edit manually the small details to have a clean blend between the two actions.
We'll be right back.